Hello, friends, brothers, and sisters. This is Big Kenny, and welcome to another Peace, Love, and Happy Hour coming at you from right here in the Pub of Love, Music City, USA. Wow, hope everybody's got themselves a chili cocktail and maybe even got yourself a good can of cocktail nuts, and you can kick back and enjoy a little Music Mafia style Peace, Love, and Happy Hour. Love you big time. Guess what? Guess what? Have I got a guest for us tonight? Friends, brothers, and sisters, let me introduce you to Rome Ramirez.
What is going on, everybody? Thanks for having me here, brother.
So happy for you to be here, Rome. And before I ask you a question or anything, I've got to just hear you sing, man.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. I said, check out the real situation. Nation, war against nation. Where does it all begin? And when will it end? But it seems like total destruction, only solution. When I said that I really want to love you, baby, but I don't want to take you away from my dreams. No, 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 not me. Because I'm so lazy, and I would rather support you, baby, emotionally, yeah. 'Cause I don't want to get a job, and I don't want to pay no bills. I don't need no short frills, baby. I just need a place to stay. Oh, so don't run away.
Wow. Wow. Let's say, tell me about this song.
I just made it up.
You just made it up?
I just made it up right now.
You completely just made that up.
I just made it up. I was like, you know, I want to write something like Amy Winehouse.
There you go. Make some noise for Brother Rome here. He just made up a song. I mean, that would be, that's true Music Mafia style. I mean, that is just being creative in the moment.
It's easier for me to make something up than it is for me to remember what I wrote.
Sometimes.
Yeah. Because, you know, I have a hard time remembering, like, lyrics. I don't think it's like the weed or something, but.
Yeah.
For me, just a freestyling, like, what's it, improv?
That's your favorite.
Yeah, I'm
place to be.
I'm good creative. At that. I've that's just how I've always played music.
Yeah.
I started playing music at parties, so
yeah.
Like it was, you know, hey, do this, hey, do that, hey, talk about that, rap about this, sing about that, play that song, and it was like, I never heard it. How's it going?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You know.
Yeah. So. And you would find something that worked with it.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Yeah. So, and so we meet.
And we're neighbors now.
Now we're neighbors. Now we're neighbors. So we get to welcome Brother Rome here to Music City, USA. Yes, Rome comes to town with an absolutely beautiful family.
Yeah,
I mean,
look
at this right there. I mean, is this pretty or what?
That's my fam.
Rio and Saint, your little ones.
Yeah.
And count my blessings every day. He says, can't believe I have a family of my own now. I learn every day from them. No one keeps it more real and with me than my beautiful, caring wife. We really are doing this shit, baby.
We really doing this.
With a big heart. Yeah.
Yep, with the biggest heart in the world.
Isn't that a crazy experience, right?
That's the craziest, man.
Falling in love. And
it's nuts, man. I think about it every day.
Family and then children. And
I was talking with my friend today. I hadn't talked to him in a minute. And he texts me. He's like, are you out of Nashville yet? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, man, that's so awesome. I wish I could do that. He's like, it's so good for the boys, for them to grow up and have that kind of lifestyle. It's so awesome that you're doing that for them. And I never really thought about it that way. Like, you know, I mean, as a parent, you know, like you make decisions, obviously, with everyone's best interest.
Yeah.
But, you know, that specifically, like, he made it seem like just so very like unselfish. And sometimes when you're just trying to get everything going, like you can't help but just be a little bit selfish, you know? 'Cause like, especially when you're the person who's kind of like you know, the provider for the family, you know, you're in your head, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, perhaps for someone to say that, I don't know, it just meant a lot to me, you know, because I was just like, you know, you're absolutely right. It's just for my boys, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. So you feel like, you know, in your world right now that you just, you know, doing things for all the right reasons, you know?
I think,
the best reasons.
I'm operating from the heart.
Taking everything into consideration.
You're just everyone into consideration.
That's it.
That's the thing.
You're respecting everything around you.
Everything around me, man. I've lived an incredible life, and I've done for the majority of it thinking about myself.
Yeah.
And, you know, for the first couple of years, for the first time in my life, these last couple of years, you know, I've been living incredibly selfless, and it's been addicting. Yeah. So I want to continue that road of like less about me, more about the people that I love and care about, and, you know, people I don't even know I've met yet.
Yeah.
Haven't met yet, you know?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's kind of my
Let's go into a little bit of your musical history. Like, just like, you know, kind of go back. Like my mother had me in choir when I was a little kid. She started this little church choir, a little country church choir. I got a picture of me back in.
That's awesome. Right?
So, you know, that's kind of where I first got introduced to it. I played saxophone in school.
I played bass clarinet.
Bass clarinet.
All right. Woodwind.
And then I saw you got on a guitar, though, at like 11 or something.
Yeah, 11.
Yeah.
When did you start playing guitar?
Well, I'd seen a guitar like during my high school years, probably like 15, 16, but really didn't have anybody around me that was playing a guitar. Yeah. The only other instrument that was in the house was an upright piano. But I bought a guitar about 2 years before I came here. I stopped on the side of the road after one day, I'd been in I got up and sang a song in a pub. Dude came up to me, tapped me on the shoulder and says, "You want to be in a band?" I was working construction at the time, but I said, "Well, sure, yeah, I'll do that." And then I stopped on the side of the road and bought a guitar. So I was like 28. So
when I came here, I was
about 30. I'd been playing a couple years and, you know, been playing a few years since.
That's incredible.
It's a life's mission.
Yeah, I started a little younger.
Yeah, you started a little younger.
I was like 11. I heard Sublime. That was the first band, actually.
Yeah.
The band that I ended up in.
Like, yeah, so now you're like in the first band. Sublime. Mm-hmm. It's now Sublime with Rome. Or Rome
Guilty
Sublime,
is charged.
The way you put
yep.
it.
No, yeah. Man, it's
actually it's one incredible. Of the crazier stories that I've heard in music. Well, just in that.
For me.
You know, what happened. Yeah, for you especially.
Yeah.
But for them, you know, it kind of just brought this whole band back to life. That it, I think, you know, people in my generation will remember the song in the 90s, What I Got,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yep,
and that was really the thing, the song that I can recall that lit them off, how I knew the name Sublime when I saw that. Yeah.
That's early what I got. In the morning,
yeah.
Rising to the
yeah.
street.
Yeah.
Light me a dead cigarette and I'll strap shoes on my feet. Yeah, that was like the first like huge hit for them, I think.
Yeah.
That was like a number one record.
Yeah. So then you ended up, you know, falling in love with their music.
Yeah.
And you ended up working in a studio.
Yep. So I moved down to L.A. I was born and raised in Northern California, and I moved down to L.A.,
Born and raised in Northern California, yep. By your parents had moved there.
Yep, my parents were originally from Southern California.
Yeah.
That's where they kind of grew up, and then they relocated up to Northern California for my dad's work.
Yeah.
And so I was born there, and it's which is really weird because my entire family is in Southern California.
Yeah.
You know, close to Mexico because my parents, you know, and their family is from Mexico.
You bring forth the best of Mexican heritage.
Dude, it's crazy, right? Man. Like,
right?
Yeah, hallelujah. It's nuts. Well, my great-grandfather was, my like great-uncle, he was a famous singer. Like in Mexico.
Oh, so, got some great uncle famous singers in the family.
Something
huh?
like
there
that.
You go.
Something now, like that. So, I mean,
saying,
you
I got
know,
a mama that was then, a choir teacher
and then, but,
for the country church.
You know,
you got a great uncle that's a singer.
Famous is, you
that's
know,
awesome.
Is you know, beauty in the eyes of the beholder. So that's my grandma saying that her grandpa was famous.
Yeah.
You know, which could be anything.
Yeah.
You know, but so I like to think that's, you know, kind of where I got some of the music from, but. Yeah, honestly, man, I fell in love with the band Sublime. I really loved that sound, and it got me just so like changed that I just wanted to start playing music. I was a kid and I heard the music and I was like, man, I'm trying to make music that sounds like that. That sounds like something I want to do as a kid. And I just wanted to learn how to play guitar and sing. So I just like started practicing and then, yeah, man, like, you know, it, anyway, long story short, like I kept with it and I moved down to Los Angeles to become a recording engineer.
Yeah.
And then hopefully kind of just meet people in the industry through that. Yeah. And then, you know, hopefully things can take off. But upon getting there, I started working at the studio in Orange County.
Yeah.
And the owner of that studio was in a band and good friends with the bass player to Sublime, Eric.
Yeah.
Who's getting married tomorrow, going to his wedding. And I mean, dude, we just met. And then after that, it was just kind of like, just, you know, history. Like,
he would host parties at his house. You'd go over there and jam with them.
Yep.
So I'd go over there and jam. Take me back there, man. Like, what was the song that would go down back then?
We'd play like a lot of like punk rock because that's what he's really into, you know what I mean? So, and I really like punk rock too. So I knew a lot of the music that he would be wanting to play. And I think that kind of like made him like me a little bit more, you know, because he obviously, there's a 25 year difference in age between us, but whatever he threw out still, you know, I'm able to jam with him.
Yeah.
So like, he musically, he trusted me, you know, like we had that connection. We have that connection still.
Yeah.
And that was like, I guess the turning point where I think, you know, he saw something in me. He had this party.
Let's take the band on the road again.
Dude,
right?
Straight up.
That's like, what happened, right?
That's pretty much it.
Y'all met up. He was inspired enough by your voice, whenever you could do whatever you were doing in that situation with what they were doing, that they're like, wow, maybe this is another singer. We can bring the band back. You know, maybe this can be. And it happened. That's crazy.
It's dude, that's crazy. Blows my mind.
Yeah.
Because he didn't, you
that's
know.
That's mind blowing. So what year was that?
2008.
You were born in 88.
Yeah.
88.
I was 8 years old when Bradley passed away.
Yeah. So for those that don't know, Sublime lost their... the lead singer of the band, and very unfortunately,
heroin overdose. Yeah, man, it's a legend. Rest in peace, Bradley.
Yeah, I remember that was one of the rules in the music mafia when we first started that. That's actually, there's this little section in here I was gonna read because I think like just meeting you and the way we met is very like music mafia, like the kind of things that happened back then in my world, in our world, you know, like John and John Nicholson and Corey Gehrman and Gretchen Wilson and Cowboy Troy and all these artists that were gathered back then and Damien. And we were all just get together, no matter, everybody played a different kind of music. And it's not going to be, our music's like, you know, covers just a lot of territories out there.
Yeah.
But it wasn't necessarily what was going to fit on country radio at that point in time, but might be good to go somewhere. But one of the things, we had a list of, just kind of rules we give our respect and accept. This is chapter 2 in the Music Mafia book. This is Music Mafia book here. Chapter 2. Chapter 2 starts out with, this guy ended up writing, just Dr. David Pruitt ended up writing this book. It's how he got his PhD, and he now teaches as a professor at like Berkeley and stuff. And he wrote this book on when we were coming together, these artists were coming together with this, every once a week Tuesday night jam at the Pub of Love. But this list of rules we'd written out, like the board says, respect and accept all forms of music, people, and forms of self-expression.
Amen.
Never speak ill will of anyone or anything. That's pretty good, right? Be the best at what you do.
I love that.
Just be the best. Do not promote yourself before any other artist. No disrespect towards women. No hard drugs.
See, yeah,
because we knew we had to save everybody. We try at least. No negativity towards other music mafia musicians. Ask what you can give to the music mafia, not what you can
get from.
Was it some old Robert or like, some old Kennedy? Right.
Yeah. Listen, good. Ask what you can do for this country.
Right?
Not what this country
can do for you.
Can do for you.
And it's crazy how much like insane, you know, successful music has like contradicted so many of like those rules. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah,
you know?
It is.
But,
it is. But
it's different now. It's a different time. You know what I mean? And I feel like a lot of people then probably lived towards that, you know, that ethos, you know, where the live fast, die young, you know?
And yeah.
I think people want to be around to like be peaceful and love more.
And
like, honestly, like why live fast, die young?
Enjoy their family. Yeah.
Let's like, you know, live just good and long as we can.
Yeah. Yeah. And healthy.
And
you
healthy.
Said you're telling me earlier, your wife.
Yeah.
Is very nutritious.
She's like, super, super, you know, nutritionist. Like, she's really into the, like the science of food, you know, more so. And you know, it's correlation with how your body and your mental can kind of get out of whack, you know? And I mean, I go on tour and I just
so when she tasted one of those
all oh, she loved
natural
it.
Peace, love, and
well, she was the one who told me,
penis.
She's like,
did she go, this is the perfect peanut.
She loved
the perfect peanut.
She told me yesterday,
this is the best cocktail nut
she
ever.
Said, don't come home without a case of peanuts. It's like, all right, I got you.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Well, hey, man, put yourself back there in that mindset where you were then, those days. We're going to bring you through the history. Play us a song. Play us a song.
I'll play you the first song I wrote when I went out
there. Okay, cool.
Take on me and break apart the everything that makes me man. So bye, won't you tell leave if I ever want to restore some sanity. I'm singing baby, 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 I'm the fool. Yeah, I tear myself in two for the vision of loving you. You, I mean, time you come around, girl, you got me tripping. Yeah, like I'm gonna lose it. And every time I talk to you, you better listen. Yeah, cause you need you between the things that'll lift you up and break it down. But baby, don't you know what's right for you lately? But I said, so won't you know that I say you gotta stop with direction and just move the right way. Cause a lot of pain inside your head. Believe you on a corner, but you can't live in this dreadful state. I know it sometimes gets crazy with me. We know we ain't got too much history, yeah. Let me tell you now, every time I talk to you, better listen, yeah. Cause you need to choose between the things that'll lead you up and wither your soul. But screw you, better know now, every time I talk to you, better listen, yeah. So you better love, screw you, better know. Cause yeah, you better choose between all of the hard things that, baby, yeah, right now. Oh, won't you choose what is right for you lately?
What do you call it?
You better listen.
You better listen.
Yeah.
From back in the day. That's the first song you wrote?
The first song I wrote when I moved down to L.A., yeah.
Yeah. And did that end up?
That made the first Sublime record.
Made it to the first Sublime.
Yours truly, the first SWR record that we put out in, I think, 2010. It's a while ago, 10 years. Wow.
I feel like I ought to play you a song.
I love that.
Feeling like Tonto, riding a Pinto, trying to chase a Lone Ranger down. I'm a little unraveled, but I'm still in the saddle, crying your name out to the cloud. Hey-ya, hey-ya. Why don't you meet me back at the teepee? We'll lay down by the campfire, and there in the dark night, we'll smoke the peace pipe, forget about who's wrong or right. Hey-ya, hey-ya. Only forgiveness we'll find in the endless. There won't be a witness if we both fall. There's never a hero in a battle of egos. There's never a winner of the quick draw. Hey-ya, hey-ya. It was a big showdown. Oh yeah, we stood our ground. Shot out the lights. It got a little crazy. Don't wanna see us go the way of the buffalo. Don't wanna have another Wild West show. Yeah, yeah. Riding a Vento, trying to chase a Lone Ranger down.
That's fucking dope.
Yeah. Wild West Show, that was the first song that John and I ever put out.
No shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wrote that with a fella named Blair Daly here in town. Blair's badass songwriter, and never forget that day. Actually, we were sitting over in a little condo John was renting at the time there in Hillsboro Village, and boy, that song says a lot, you know. That's crazy. What's so cool about songs, you know.
It really brings you right back to that moment too.
Yeah. So you also, I guess, when I met you, our unique connection there is brother Mike Brown.
Yep.
Cheese, who manages Travis Tritt, manages you and
Dirty Heads.
Yeah. So yeah.
Also gave him some grandkids too.
Yeah. And then y'all have
some
to be
records,
related.
Some grandkids.
Yeah.
Nah, man, it's crazy because like he was one of the first people to like find me out in Southern California. My manager, Cheese. Everyone calls him Cheese, so let's call him Cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he heard my stuff, and he was like, "You're a talented kid, you know, what do you want to do?" You know, he asked me, he's like, "What are you trying to do?" I'm like, "I just want to play music. I don't really care for being rich. I just want to be able to make a, you know, just pay my bills and be able to play music, you know." Yeah. And you know, so he would kind of develop me and have me in the studio where
That's unusual, because most managers wouldn't necessarily react when you told them something like that.
No, of course not, right?
They want to hear somebody wants to conquer the world, you know, right? Musically at least.
I was just like, listen, like I just want to play music, you know what I mean? Like, however big enterprise business you can do with it, cool. But I don't come from a music industry background.
Yeah.
I come from the streets, man. Like, all my friends are in gangs. You know what I mean? I lost like 6 friends before I graduated high school. So it's like, to me, like band, songwriting, producing, that shit was like, on the radar. You know what I mean?
That's crazy. You know what you said, what you just said, you know, you grew up in gangs. 6 of your friends were before what? Give me that statistic. And before what time again?
Like leaving high school.
Before you left high school, 6 of your friends had been killed.
Yeah, straight up.
Yeah. So that would have been, I mean, you're out of high school now for a 18? Decade and a half.
Yeah.
So is that better or worse now?
Well, I mean,
thankfully,
the grace of music, man, like I'm no longer in there anymore. Neither is my parents.
Yeah. But how about, is it still there? Has it changed any? Do you feel like the situation for kids that are like you that are coming up there now have changed any?
Probably not. Well, actually, yes, in the way that now, because when I was a kid, we didn't get, like, you know, internet. I know that sounds crazy, but we didn't get the internet until, like, maybe I was about 17 years old, 16. Yeah. 16 years old was when we started getting, like, high-speed internet, you know, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And so we never had any sort of way of like putting out music and stuff. It wasn't until I was older, like until MySpace came around, where you were able to put out music on your own.
Yeah.
But now I feel like, and statistically speaking, I can't speak on whether or not the murders have gone up or down in the area. But what I can speak on is that I do know that now, technologically speaking, we do have outlets now where you can put out art for millions of people to see. Mm-hmm. Depending on the quality of the
basically just like music. This and brothers and sisters, you can do it live.
You can
in Technicolor. Yes,
and
straight
if it's
from the
good
pub.
People will watch.
They want more of it, right?
And if it sucks, they won't. And that's how it goes. If I open up a burger stand tomorrow, it's the same thing.
It's like anybody has an opportunity, pretty much, to try and do anything that they can.
And that has to help.
Especially
that has to help with people who are. I mean, even the way we grew up, man, we were frustrated. We were fucking mad.
Yeah.
We were pissed. We didn't know who, but we were just pissed.
Yeah.
Because we can all see them right across the way. There was a high school, and there were kids who had bigger houses and drove nice cars at 16 and had this and did that, and we had none of that. And we didn't understand why. We had our auto mechanics class had to get cut, but they got an extra this and that and that. You know, like, there's this confusion that you can't really... You can't blame children because we haven't lived an experience. So frustration happens and bad shit happens. But anyway, circling back, at least now with the advent of the internet, I feel like people can use that frustration and get it out to the world a lot easier.
There you go, brothers and sisters. Use that frustration and get it out the door.
Whether
Rome just said it,
whether
no matter
it's a T-shirt,
what,
a song, a video.
Yeah, I mean, be creative.
A Shopify store where you make cat collars.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Use that frustration to be creative. Use that frustration to be creative and make things happen. Maybe just, you know, throw a show for all your friends and just bring a little happiness and joy to the world.
That's
and
all
nothing
you can
less, because Lord knows we need more of that. I mean,
we
especially
can use it.
Especially in times like this. Speaking of that, since it is peace, love, and happy hour here. What do you think? I mean, what do you think that we can do? It's no doubt, you know, we've mentioned it before. We're living in trying times, man. It really seems like, you know, we've got so many things that we're up against. And this is typically the stuff that as songwriters and artists, you know, a lot of songs have gotten me through some of the, you know, some of the toughest stuff. You kind of feel like people are relating it, but also there's got to be solutions. And I've said, you know, one of the things that I've hoped and I've prayed for is just that everybody's able to hear each other, man. That we don't put up, that we understand that we're all in this together, man. And we can at least hear each other when it comes right down to it. We all just want to survive and thrive. And thrive. And have the abilities to pursue happiness and those kind of fun things. But we just want to be able to coexist, respect and love one another. What do you... what are the simple things that you see? I mean, what is it? I mean, we come from two totally different things. Yeah. I think it's important that we got to, you know, be able to sit and understand here and go, you know, I was raised up in a country school. You know, it was totally different.
The opposite of what I did.
Yeah. What you're raised, but still tough. But the way stuff, I see man. It, man, I was bullied. It was just, it was bad.
But we all want not the same. Fun. We all want the same shit, though. All of us.
Exactly.
From top to bottom, from left to right, we all want the same thing. We all want to belong.
Yeah.
We all want some sense of tribe. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
We all want to spend time with the people we love. Spend time, and we don't want to have to worry about food. You know what I mean? So like all the basic principles that I feel like everybody wants are all similar. They're all super similar. And we forget that, because that is the most humanizing part about people is the essentials. You know what
have
I mean?
Have you ever met anybody who didn't love their kids?
No. Exactly, man. Exactly. Have you ever met anybody who doesn't want to sit outside and eat with their family? You know what I'm saying?
Fortunately, that is probably one of the things that we can do right now is sit outside and eat with our family. Good to be outside, social distancing.
But and so I feel like, you know, we can kind of confuse things and complicate things. You know what I mean? And the media does a damn good job at dividing everybody and putting them in there. You guys talk with these guys and you hang out with these people, you know?
I want to hang out with everybody, man.
Well, ain't it funny how, like, when you're out at a concert and you're surrounded by people of all different ethnicities and walks of life,
and you guys are all just enjoying music.
Because in that moment, we're all, like, we all want the same shit, you know? Yeah. We all just want to have a good time.
Yeah.
We forget about that when we start throwing
brands on us. Isn't
that
one of the crazy things of what has happened this year is just being away from that for this period of time?
Look what's happening.
Oh, yeah. Everybody's just trying to get back out there.
I have friends that are even going through this that have just been away from people for so long that are mentally just thinking ill.
Yeah.
You know, where you're like.
You forget that joy. You can. It's possible. Brothers and sisters, We pray for all of us here tonight that we don't forget the joy that does come when we all get to get together, congregate, and celebrate. So although we may be doing it at a little bit of a distance right here, right now, we still want to make sure that you all feel and know that we're feeling it. We're feeling it come back from you, man, and everybody from all these places all across the world and the country, shore to shore, man, y'all showing up here with the comments and stuff and saying hello to us, and it's just, you know, always beautiful to see that we're all still connecting out there, even in this crazy time. And man, just the music, just knowing that it is gonna, you can't, it, the music will always be played, whether I'm hearing it like this or however. I heard one of our guests last week saying that even though we had a video thing that was, you know, the buffer was bad, it wasn't coming through, she said, no worries, I've got it turned up on my big speakers and I'm just kicked back and listening. Right. And then another one just had it on their headphones, so the audio was coming through great. But, you know, one way or the other, you take the best of whatever you get.
That's all you can do, right?
Go from there.
That's all you can do.
Yeah.
A little bit of less news, more conversation.
Yeah.
You need to talk. Yeah. I think if people ask, like, what can I do? Don't be quiet right now. Just talk.
Yeah, just talk. Just to have people. A conversation.
Have
here
a conversation
what we're doing.
Just like this, like, man. And especially if it's opposing views, have that conversation with your uncle or your brother, your best friend, or whatever.
Yeah.
But talk, because it's important for us to talk about all of this stuff. Like everything, man. Communication is crucial.
Communication is crucial. Cheers. Here's a brothers and sisters. We're going to have a cheers tonight. This is a toast to hearing and communicating. Communication is crucial. Cheers. Yep. Throw them back. Love you big time. Peace, love, and happy hour coming at you here from the pub of love. And it's a good time we're having it with Brother Rome Ramirez. Now, Rome, I was just getting into earlier about how we knew each other. Okay, now you're a manager. We're friends. And thus, I got introduced to the band Dirty Heads.
Yep.
And you also
Y'all have worked together. Y'all put out forever. Stuff too, right?
Yep, yep. Those are my boys.
Yeah. Duddy and Jared.
Yep. Yeah, me and Duddy, I've known all the guys forever.
Well, so I met them. We got to, you know, hang out and explore creativity a little
That's
bit.
Awesome.
Get to meet it. It's good stuff. Yeah.
They're good dudes, man. They're cut from the same cloth, you know. They're just blessed to be doing music for a living, you know. Never thought that we'd be here.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're here and we just don't want to mess it up. Don't want to have to go get a job at Staples, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
But no, they're great. They're killing the game, man. They're playing, I mean, no one's playing anywhere right now, but
they've been like last year, they were touring.
Oh man, they've had the biggest year of their lives. They've had some big songs on the radio and they've been headlining their own amphitheater shows and they're killing it.
They're playing all over the place.
Couldn't be more proud, man.
So before this ended, before the touring world ended this year, you were out in multiple incarnations and you would possibly tour with them.
Yep. So Sublime with Rome just had this was back in February, March.
Or this last year, I mean, like that's
year,
right?
I mean, for a typical year, yeah. I'll be out on tour with the guys, and then I'll come home, and then, you know, the singer and the guitar player for the Dirty Heads, Duddy B, we have a side project called Roman Duddy, very original, and we just kind of wanted to break down our songs and then kind of also work on some new music, kind of in the vein of just like some Americana, like reggae kind of fused tunes. Something where we can just kind of roll in with just our guitars and storytell.
Mm-hmm.
You know, after watching a Travis Tritt performance that she's invited us both to, we were just like, dude. Like,
when he's sitting up there with a guitar.
Sitting up there storytelling.
Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, if you have not seen Travis Tritt's theater show yet, you need to check it out. Man. Him sitting there with a the guitar telling stories.
Mind blown.
Here's a quarter. Call someone.
Right? Here's what that quarter's from. Here's what I was talking about when I wrote that. You know, I was thinking about that quarter. Like that whole stuff where it was just like, a light bulb went off in our heads and we were like, yo, we got to do this, man. We should do something like this for the fans. And it just sounds fun.
Yeah.
And dude, we did it and it was really successful. The fans loved it. Shows were selling out and the promoters were up in the venues and, you know, COVID cut it short.
Yeah.
And, you know, but that's okay because, you know, we're already booking it for next year.
Yeah.
We'll be ready to rock again.
They've just continued to move our dates forward. Like they continue to move our dates forward. And so if any of y'all out there, you know, if they've had a ticket or whatever somewhere, I know I've seen a lot of you comment online also that you've either moved the ticket forward or however that one worked out. But so we're planning on playing. Everybody's just looking at the situation on a daily basis and trying to make decisions of what can be done, you know, what states there's no COVID in, or there are areas that there's no COVID in, that the people still want to throw these fairs and stuff, and also benefit all the communities. You know, a lot of these places where we'll play, you know, some of these fairs and festivals, the big ones across the country that have been going for hundreds of years, were set up to benefit their community. So they might fund the United Way. It might be the Kiwanis Club.
The money goes to great places.
And they're going there to, like, so if it's not happening, then it's not happening. So they want to have these things happen any way they possibly can. So it's just a terrible predicament that we're up against
right now.
There's got to be just more songs that come out of this sort of a thing. You know, it's the most unnatural thing for musicians, especially because we're all about getting people together.
Literally, that's
right.
That's our job,
let's
bring
all
people
come
together.
And we'll find our commonalities with the music, man. And people standing next to people, they, like you were saying earlier, that they might never stand beside because of the music. So, I guess there couldn't be a group of people out there rooting for a vaccine any bigger than we are. Because we want to protect everybody, but we want to get everybody back to, you know, those joyful places too.
I can't imagine playing a socially distanced show, you know, where people are like 10 feet away from each other. Like, that'd be crazy.
Well, you've been seeing some of the drive-in stuff.
I saw a couple.
So they're like set the, I know there's, well, Brad Paisley's getting ready to do one, and it seemed like it was every third car spot in a parking lot becomes a like a party zone, and people got to stay within their, you know, the spot and the spot next door to them. And then there's got to be a whole spot as a a car space as a distance, and then another car.
But I guess it's better than
nothing.
Trip on that, man.
Better than nothing.
Trip on that.
Mad Dog 2020. Better than nothing. Moonshine. Better than nothing. Yeah, it's wow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah that here we are sitting here in the pub of love, making a little
thank
music
God for that.
And singing some songs.
Dude, it's times like this where I'm so like grateful to be a musician. I'm honored to be a musician.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have a job right now. That's fine.
Yeah.
But I don't care because I'm honored to be able to be on that side where I can directly contribute with music.
Yeah.
You know, I do these live streams on my Twitch channel with my fans, and like they literally tell me, it's like, just coming here on Friday knowing that you're going to be playing music and singing, it's like the highlight of the week. You know what I mean? And that's free for me to do. I can wake up and do that. Like that's a God-given gift.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So that's the way that you can work too. That's the way you give back, you know?
That's how I can work, you know? And I don't think really right now, like very, very few musicians, I mean, obviously if you're struggling, but very few musicians that are in this position right now are really looking at things for like monetary gain.
Yeah.
It's more so just, you know, at least all of my peers, like, we're just like, how can we continue to put music out?
Mm-hmm.
How can we help with what we do for a living?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and
keep
that
it
makes me proud as hell, man.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
I'm proud of being a musician.
So what would you tell people? I mean, you've evidently been able to get to a point where you've made a living. You've made a living making music, doing the thing that you dreamed of and wanted to do. What's the number one thing you would tell people? Because that's a struggle, man. I know it takes years and years of believing that you're going to get to that point where you can actually make a nickel of it. But you got to just do it because you feel like you're destined to do it. You just got to do it.
I think do it is the – that's – to me, that was the – to me, man, from one thing I've always seen growing up is like from – there's very few people I know to this day even who actually do – I have mad smart friends who can like plan, put together a super sick plan, or guys who can do like marketing for labels and this and that, or all these guys that, you know, can do the research and all this, but like not a lot of people just get up and do something and fall on their ass. You're gonna fall, you're gonna eat some shit, but you gotta love it because it's what you do. It's what defines you.
Yeah.
You love it so much that you don't care if you eat shit because it's what defines you. You falling on your ass has to turn you on.
Yeah.
It really does.
And falling on your ass has to turn you on. Yeah.
You know, like
because
there's no other way.
Because what's going to happen.
Because if you want to make a good buck, it's a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
So you better just love what it is that you're getting told no about all the time, you know?
Yeah. And ultimately, you know, what magically kind of happens every time you're told no is you keep doing it. You keep getting better. You keep getting better. And then all of a sudden, the no's start going away. And
more yeses happen. You start meeting people who can open new doors for you.
Yeah.
It's crazy how it works. When
it's really
when you give yourself in,
sort of thing, huh?
You let go of the ego. You know, you're open to change. You're open to growth.
Yeah.
Growth. You're open to growth. You know what I mean?
Growth.
When no one's listening to your songs and you got a handful of people telling you that your songs could be better, maybe you should listen.
Maybe you should listen.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Because, you know, you're right for the people. The world isn't your audience. It's whoever's listening.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And if you got that's people it. Listening, then you should be honest.
That's really the proof right now in anything, isn't it?
It is right now. Right now. It's funny. Because I was talking about this on like an interview that I had a couple weeks ago with Forbes, and they were talking about this whole COVID thing and about what the live streaming and everything. And right now is like all the smoke and mirrors is gone. Like if you were like this like major label plant that had all these like marketing budgets and that shit's gone. Like, if you don't have real fans right now, mm-hmm. you're not doing nothing. You're not getting no action on the socials, like nothing. But if you are about your people and if you've always been about your people and if you always serviced your fans and you've always been good to them and giving back to them and continually, even now in this rut where us as musicians don't have a job and we're still continually thinking about them, like you're not getting paid for this. This is costing you money.
Somebody might buy a 6-pack of peanuts. Matter of fact, they come in 3-packs, 6-packs.
But it don't matter. You do it for free even if you didn't have the peanuts.
Absolutely. I'm trying to do this. You know? We do our peanuts. The peanuts fund's a Love Everybody Fund. One of the things we've been doing here, you know, I've been helping my fifth grade teacher, you know, as an example, down in outside of Tampa, Florida. In 2010, she came up here and found me when I was trying to help on another project after the Haiti disaster that happened. And she said that she realized there were kids coming to school hungry. That's in 2010, ridiculous. There were kids coming to school hungry. And that's why they were not learning at school. Yeah. So I'm like, that can't be. This, you got to be kidding me. There are kids in America that are hungry? What's going on here? So, you know, this gives me, a way to say to bring the awareness to the fact that there still are children that come to school hungry. As of this past year, they were doing 900 backpacks in that area, the Operation Heartfelt.
That's incredible.
Operation Heartfelt in Florida. And so we've been helping out however we could since 2010 to help those guys. And, you know, here we are, you know, right here at the 4th of July. And, you know, we think you can't help but just also just think of how great this country is, how blessed we all are to be this great celebration of us becoming this country that is now and that was then and is today the United States of America, that all these unique people and unique cultures that are brought together under this one beautiful flag, you know, contains these colors, red, white, and blue. And it's just all of us, united together.
Yep.
And man, if music can help us find the best of what we all are together, and it always has, then it just seems like that's the way. And that's our tool, our blessing to bring awareness and help out and feed kids, to make sure that every veteran's, you know, got a voice and is taken care of, just to do all the things that are important, not only in our families, but then the next step with me is our community.
Our community,
you know, our family, our communities, our country.
Well, that's how it spills out, right?
That's how it's stacked, really. Yep. It's not, it can never be from a top down anyway. No president's ever going to solve every problem. I mean,
it's
got to
ripple
Christ,
out.
It's got to be from the families and the communities. We're all in this together, you know.
We
and, when we look at it as communities and break them up like that, then, you know, I think it's pretty amazing, honestly, that I just feel so, I mean, blessed that I got to be raised up like I did, whether I thought it was tough or not, whether you thought it was tough or not.
No, same.
It was still a blessing.
It's still an absolute blessing. Even just to even be here and be able to talk about it in past tense, you know, like I just think that those are the kind of opportunities that people may take for granted, but we can't, you know.
Well, it's important. A blessing to hear you sing a song, so why don't you sing me another one?
Oh, man, okay.
Ramirez.
Run away, I need time to figure out. Wide awake, I'm seeing signs of slowing down. Because I wake up in the morning, think about the night. Every drink we're pouring starts another fight. I'm a hazard to our health, we do it to ourselves every night. Ooh, every night. Because who knew, nobody can hurt me like you do. Stuck me in your heart like voodoo. Go and make your mark, come, I love you from afar. That's your wicked heart, na-na. I know you mean no harm, baby, bless your wicked heart. Na-na. But I love you from afar, baby, bless your wicked heart. Na-na. I love you from afar, baby, bless your wicked heart. Your heart. Then I said, I don't know. I don't know when it's home, what to say anymore. 'cause I swear that I wrote and I done and I sang the same shit that you've heard before. Because you wake up in the morning and think about the night. Oh, every morning pouring and we start another fight. From a hazard to our health, we do it to a stealth every night. Ooh, every time. 'Cause who knew nobody can hurt me like you do? Stop me in the dark like voodoo. Go make your mark, I'ma love you from afar. Bless your wicked heart, na la, na la. I know you mean no harm, baby. Bless your wicked heart, na la, na la. But I love you from afar, baby. Bless your wicked heart, la la, ooh la la. But I love you from afar, baby. Bless your wicked heart. Your heart, your heart, your heart, your heart. Bless your wicked heart.
Something like Jeez. That. That's powerful. That's a good spot. Thanks, in your man. Voice, man.
Yeah.
Super good spot. Super good spot there in the voice. Yeah, so what do you dream of these days? I mean, what's your, like...
Providing, man, for just a good childhood for my family.
Yeah.
For my boys, you know?
Yeah, yeah. How old are they now? Tell me again.
Three and 8 months old.
3 and 8 months old. Wow.
Yo, I'm going to take a quick leak, actually.
I remember that.
I got all the right. Jack okay. Daniels kind of running.
He's just going to cut for 1 second.
Just 1 second.
Where's your instrument?
It's a boom. Wrong.
You got a red stripe? Right,
yes, we do.
Let's see what happens, man.
All right. Oh, yeah, baby.
How's that treat you?
Thank you, my brother. Verses, man, just lend itself to the pen. Struggles on my mistakes,
all my struggles just melt away.
You can melt away. All my struggles just melt away. Yeah. All my problems, all my mistakes, all my troubles.
There you go.
All my troubles. So that's what you keep saying. I keep thinking, all my struggles, all my pain, all my struggles. Melt away. Every time I see your face, I'm yesterday.
Every time I see your face, I'm better than yesterday. That's
all my troubles, my mistakes, all my struggles, they melt away. Every time that I see your face, I can't help thinking I see. Yeah. Only one love.
Been across the border, through the states, been through the troubles, but we can't look away. We've got history and every word, but I don't know.
'Cause it's only one love. Say it again, everybody, say, only one love. Hey, everybody, join me and my friend, Rome Ramirez, for another chapter, maybe another book, of The Music Mafia. Music without prejudice. Love everybody. It's peace, love, and happy, y'all. Let's have some fun at the pub of love. Yeah, yeah! Lay the book down! Yeah, lay the book down!
Yeah, baby.
So, Brother Rome, I was gonna, you know, probably one of the simplest songs I got is this one that people know called Save a Horse, Ride a Cowboy. And I thought maybe, you know, I'd play that for you too. But if there's anything, you know, else that you want to tell the folks or the people or anything, you know, I'm, you know, wide open to make sure we include everything that you want to get. Out there, you know, I want to tell everybody, you know, check this guy out when we get out back cranking back out, you know.
You find me and all the social medias, Rome Ramirez and from my band, Sublime with Rome. You know, I'm heading out to Texas. My boy Eric, our bass player, he's getting married tomorrow. So we're heading out there. And you know, we have very, very beautiful lives, you know. And all of us to be able to do music for a living is an absolute blessing. It really is. Ask any musician. And you know, we wouldn't have these lives if it wasn't for the fans and for you guys. So thank you for just giving us these stages to do this. And times are weird, but band together.
Yeah.
That's what this is for, you know. We'll come out stronger because of it, you know. We have to do a lot of learning and a lot of loving right now.
Yeah. So. Absolutely. Passing out $100 bills, and it kills and it thrills like the horns on my Silverado grill. Now by the bar, triple round the crown, and everybody's getting down in this town. It ain't never gonna be the same. 'Cause I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Be riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Well, I don't give a damn about nothing. I'm singing and bling blinging while the girls are drinking. Long necks down, I wouldn't trade old Leroy on my Chevrolet for your Escalade, your freak parade. I'm the only John Wayne left in this town. And I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Be riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, what? Save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Well, I'm a thoroughbred, that's what she said in the back of my truck bed as we was getting a little buzzed on suds out on some what backcountry road. We were flying high, fine as wine, just having ourselves a big and rich time, and I was going about as far as she let me go. Oh, but her evaluation of my cowboy reputation left me begging for salvation all night long. Woo! So I took her out a kicking frog, introduced her to my old bird dog, sang her every Gretchen Wilson song I could think of, and we made love. And I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Be riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. What? What? Save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody say it loud. Save a horse, ride a cowboy. Yeah, yeah! Love you all big time. Thank you so much for being here. Big Kenny, love seeing you. Peace, love, and happy hour. This is my friend Rome Ramirez. Make sure you check him out, follow him, and just enjoy the moment. God bless you all.
So much.
God bless the times. The future is bright. Love you big time.
Give me some music, time to kick back. A beverage and a perfect snack. Deliciously crunchy, gourmet, hand-cooked, peace, love, and happy hour. Premium Virginia peanuts. Get them in sea salt, unsalted, jalapeno, fiery chipotle, and chili lime. I'm talking a good time. Start your own stack. Grab a three-pack. Peace, love, and happyhour.com.
Hey!